Today my guest is Anke Vondung, who is playing the role of Dulcinea in Massenet's Don Quixote. Welcome.
Hello, welcome.
Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Now, you were last with us as Sophie. No, excuse me, Octavian. Sorry, I got my roles mixed up. As Octavian in Der Rosenkavalier,
yes.
And that's when we had the opportunity to meet you and work with you the first time. And that's why you're back, because we love you so much. And it's just terrific.
Yeah, I love to be back.
Just
yeah.
Terrific to have yeah. you here. Tell me, though, about Dulcinea. You've never sung this role before?
No, this will be my debut with this role.
Okay, so tell me, did you even know the role? Did you
no.
know of this opera? Have you seen it before?
No, I haven't seen it. It's not often done nowadays. It comes up sometimes.
A little bit more.
A little
yeah.
bit more.
Yeah.
But yeah, so.
And thanks to us, because we've done it twice now.
Yeah, yeah.
In
yeah,
like
yeah.
six
yeah,
or
it's
seven
a
years.
Wonderful, it's a wonderful piece.
Well, I'm going to ask you, as a singer approaching a role for the very first time, what is that like? What's your process? How do you study it? How do you get into it? How do you make up your mind who Dulcinea is?
Yeah, well, yeah. First, I mean, you have to learn the music.
The notes, yeah. yeah.
Notes, music, text. You try to understand what it means, blah, blah, blah. Vocabulary, everything. And you learn it as good as it is possible. Then you looking around what's going on in the other acts where you're not in, and how is the story,
see how everything fits,
what's yeah. happening, where I am in the beginning, what's the role about. But yeah, but you yeah then in the process of working on it here like on stage, then you with all the other people, then you then it gets more and more like, okay, who is she, what is she doing, why.
So when you first saw it, what was your immediate reaction? What did you think? Did you think,
I can do this?
Good. I'm glad that was your reaction. That's wonderful. Well, you know, yeah. I mean, in a way, that's terrific. So you felt immediately, this is not going to be a big problem. There's
no
challenging
no.
sections or anything
no.
like that.
No.
And you're only in two acts.
Yes.
Well, you come at the very end also, but
yeah,
it's not
two acts.
Yeah. Who is this character most like in the roles that you've already done? Who is she similar to?
Well, she's quite kind of similar to another opera, which is written by a French composer writing a Spanish opera.
Carmen. But I guess what I was getting at was, have you sung Carmen?
Yeah, yeah.
You have sung Carmen.
Yeah, yeah.
So you found them somewhat similar?
It's the all the Spanish thing around, and she's another character. She's much younger, I think, and she's a little bit of another character, but...
Mm-hmm.
There are some, musically as well,
mm-hmm.
some bits and pieces where I said, aha, okay, this is, there are some things which...
There's a little bit of an influence, perhaps,
Bizet
on Massenet.
Yeah, yeah.
It was interesting talking to Ferruccio, who's our Quixote, yesterday. He said there's a little bit of influence from Boris.
Yeah.
From Boris Godunov.
Oh, yeah, is it? Well...
On Quixote.
Yeah.
Because in the death scene, that there were, he found similarities in the music.
Yeah, possible.
Which is interesting.
Yeah.
But yeah, you can't, it's funny, I've been saying it a lot, that French composers are so good about faking Spanish music. it's all made up, you know, they're not Spanish, there's not a drop of Spanish blood in Massenet. Well, maybe there is, but
yeah.
he really gets the flavor, doesn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah.
You've got two arias that are almost even... influence of a little flamenco, because they have this these introductions
and
that
have,
are very improvised.
There's always this kind of lala of these
yeah.
where you have the idea of, okay, this is going to be like a flamenco dance around.
Is that as much fun as it looks and sounds?
Yeah, it is.
So you're playing with a little bit.
Yeah. And I mean, I'm especially love the French words and language and.
Mm-hmm.
Doing lots of French stuff as well.
Is it a good libretto? Does it speak well? Does it feel good.
Yeah, for me, yes. Yeah, yeah. It's very very poetic in many corners.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that where you can use the words very intimate, and you can
mm-hmm.
play with it, and this is fun.
The tragedy, of course, of Don Quixote is in the fourth act, when she has to turn him away. Have you haven't gotten to the rehearsal of that scene yet, have you?
No, not really.
Not quite.
No.
I'm wondering how that can affect you as a singer in the moment. Touching moments like that, I think you have to be, don't you have to be very careful vocally?
No.
No?
No. No, I don't think so. This is, if you're in the role, that, you know, that will do whatever it has to do.
So you're not going to burst into tears when you have to... tell Quixote, no, I'm not the woman for you.
Yeah, well, perhaps a little bit. Why not? But, you know, that's in the piece.
It's part of dealing with,
I mean, it's clear that he's nothing for her. He's just, this is, from the very beginning, this is clear.
Mm-hmm.
But he touches her in another way, because he's just... She feels that he is a wonderful soul. He's a beautiful heart and warm, and he means what he's saying, and apart all of his visions and whatever.
Mm.
But as a personality or as a wonderful soul, she's going to recognize this in the piece more and more.
That's a transformation for her, though, isn't it?
Mm.
That she begins very much as a kind of party girl and
superficial
maybe, and not, you know, she sends him off on his quest, but she has to change. And that's a challenge, I think, for an actress, is it not?
Yeah, it is. I bet the beginning is that joyful playing. I mean, she has always these melancholic, kind of depressing moments where she's really, where you can see as an audience as well that she's quite alone.
Mm.
Because there is all this going around her and blah blah blah, but she's alone because there is nobody who's really taking care of her or is really understand what's going on with her or what she wants. And he's corresponding to this a bit, and that's very touching.
I really find it one of the most touching moments in opera. It's really a lovely, lovely moment, and that I think we can all look forward to. What is next for you when you leave San Diego?
When I leave San Diego, I'm going back to the other French composer with his Spanish opera.
Oh, Bizet! Oh, okay! So you're spending a lot of time in fake Spain.
In fake
is
Spain,
what you're doing.
Yes, that's what I do.
And what company?
This is the Staatsoper Dresden.
In Dresden?
In Germany, yes.
Wonderful. And are you looking forward to seeing Carmen again?
Yeah.
It's
we did a wonderful, nice production this year, so there are just a few more performances now.
Oh, wonderful. Well, thank you for being in San Diego, for coming here.
Thank you.
I hope Dulcinea becomes as familiar a role with you.
We have just the second day of rehearsal, so there's lots of time.
I know, but I hope you get to do it again.
It
seems like it's exciting for you.
It is.
That's great.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you.